Well, my first thought is I apologize for missing yesterday. I was in Sioux Falls at a Staters meeting and should have been proactive and changed it, so I apologize. Good to get the win versus Butler. I thought Butler did some good things. Great crowd, great evening. Stayed pretty healthy, so it was a good game for us. And then jumping in the Missouri Valley, one of our tougher road trips and one of our tougher opponents in Missouri State. I'm very impressed with everything about their program. And the thing that most impresses me is how fast Coach Petrino has built that thing up. And so credit to him and his players, and we're looking forward to the challenge.
We'll open for questions. First question will come from Zach Borg with Dakota News Now.
Coach, I think this is the first time you've played them since Petrino took over. He's obviously kind of known for his offense and being kind of innovative. How do you, from what you've seen on tape so far, how do you defend them, and what are the challenges they present?
They're very skilled, starting with the quarterback. And not only is he very athletic, but he's a great decision maker. I don't know if you can use the term stop them. I think the goal would be to prevent the big play and make them settle maybe for something less than they wanted to in a play and be patient and look for an opportunity to get a sack or get an interception or just get a stop. But their stats and their performance speaks for itself, and their players are really, really good on offense.
They could have a fairly big crowd. Obviously, it won't be like the one you saw the last time you were in a road game, but do you feel like some of those issues with the silent counts or some of the false start issues you had won't be a problem now as you go into more road games and more hostile environments?
I do. I thought there wouldn't be a problem at Iowa, but we weren't able to create that type of environment, and that was on us as coaches. We're looking forward to the environment. We're looking forward to the buildup of the game, and we want to go down and start off league play, just playing as the best football we can and see what happens, because it's going to be a real challenge against those guys.
And I guess lastly, how much important was it to kind of get the game you did against Butler to really, especially boost your offense's confidence? I know we've talked about the big plays were there, but just to have that game as a springboard in seems kind of important now that you're into it.
Well, I think just the first series against Butler, Zach, when we were right down the field and Mark was on and our blocking was on and Isaiah was running as well or better than he ever has, and I think all that adds to the result of the game and us feeling better. But, we as coaches can take a win and make our players feel bad, or we can take a loss, make our fielders play feel good, And it's really in the closed room where we build the confidence and show guys where we can get better also when we've had a good game.
Next question will come from Alvaro Torres with End Zoners.
Hi, Coach. Thank you for your time. Well, the team looked much better against Butler. Do you think that you can maintain that great performance against a really good team like Missouri State?
I was impressed with Butler, all right? I was impressed with their schemes. I was impressed with how well they were coached. Our program's maybe a little further down the road. Ideally, we can do some of the things we did in the Butler game in the Missouri State game and build on that. But it's a different league, a different level. I mean, I don't know how many transfers, but it's like almost playing in another FBS game in a sense with what he's done to that program, and it's super. I commend him for it. So ideally, our offense, defense, special teams will come to play and we'll handle the environment, and we'll be able to do some things on the field.
Well, Mark Gronkowski stood out after two not-so-great games. We will see the best version of him again as in his freshman season.
Is that about Mark Gronkowski? Is that what you asked? Again, I think that's somewhat dependent on the coaching staff. Yesterday's practice was not sharp. It wasn't. And it's not because Mark Gronkowski doesn't try or our offense doesn't try. We put a lot of new stuff in. And so there's a lot on the quarterback. in terms of, you know, a new read here, a new formation here, and then along with him being a mechanical engineer and having real tough classes, his mind is full. And so we as coaches need to either whittle that down or not add any more and just give him continued reps at that stuff. And I expect that to happen today. I expect Mark to play at a real high level. That's the type of young man he is.
And my last question is, you almost beat Iowa in your first game, and this week both North Dakota State and Missouri State have been close to beating other Power 5 teams. Do you feel like this conference and its teams can compete with the best in the FBS?
The best would be Alabama, no. Can we have a day against an FBS team and play them tough? Are we at a FBS level? I don't think we are, but I do think this is the premier FCS league in America, and that the top teams can compete at times with FBS programs. And you know, you look at the mentality of that. You know, who's the pressure on? It's the FBS team. Who's the excitement about playing? It's the FCS team. So there's some mental dynamics too about that whole situation that we got beat by Division III school early in our reclassification. So I've been on the other end of that, playing a lesser team, and it's a unique situation. But this is a really good league, is what I'm indicating.
Thank you for your time, Coach.
You bet.
Move on to Andrew Holton with the Brookings Register for the next questions.
John, just for some perspective, you know, how impressive has it been with Coach Petrino's turnaround, taking them when he took over? They only had one win, and now back-to-back playoff appearances, and now they're, you know, ranked in the top five of the FCS.
I think in some sports it happens a lot easier. I think in football, because you build a football program, normally it takes more time. We've seen that year in and year out, you know, of guys, really good coaches starting off, and they have losing seasons, but yet they get the program where coach has it. And so I've said it a number of times. I'll say it again. I'm very impressed with Missouri State's football program, what Coach Petrino has done.
Does it help, you know, in preparing for them that they've played three tough teams? You know, they've been in some close games where they've kind of shown everything so far.
They'll have some new stuff. I think when you have a game where you can rest some of your players, that might help. I don't know about showing offense and defense, but we as coaches, at least we at South Dakota State, we don't hold anything back. We don't hide anything. We're going to do everything we can to win a football game, because you don't get a lot of shots, and you better use all your ammunition.
So you guys going to get anyone back on the defensive side of the ball this weekend?
We are not, no. We lost a player from the game that played in the game, so we're really going the wrong direction again.
And we'll go back to Zach Borg for the next question.
Last year, you guys were really good on the road, and that extended into the playoffs. Certainly, to get to where you want to get this year, you're going to have to be very good on the road. What about last year's team allowed it to travel so well, and what do you hope carries over with this group?
Well, we had a lot of experience, senior experience. You know, we have a very mature football team, whatever we're doing, whether we're doing a service project or traveling or at home. Our guys understand they don't get a lot of shots, a lot of games, and so when we go somewhere, we go to Springfield, Missouri, to play a football game, and there's nothing else on our minds. They get about an hour with their family Friday night, and then a few minutes with them after the game on Saturday. And other than that, it's all business. And that starts with the leadership of our football team and our assistant coaches. So I think we've always been that mindset. Sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. But you know, we're not going to Springfield to sightsee.